war. War never changes. When atomic fire consumed the Earth, those who survived did so in great underground vaults. When they opened, their inhabitants set out across the ruins of the old world to build new societies, establishing villages, forming tribes. As decades passed, what had been the American Southwest united beneath the flag of the new California Republic, dedicated to old world values of democracy and the rule of law. As the Republic grew, so did its needs. Scouts spread east, seeking territory and wealth in the dry and merciless expanse of the Mojave Desert. They returned with tales of a city untouched by the warheads that had scorched the rest of the world, and a great wall spanning the Colorado River. The NCR mobilized its army and sent it east to occupy Hoover Dam and restore it to working condition. But across the Colorado, another society had arisen under a different flag. A vast army of slaves forged from the conquest of 86 tribes, Caesar's Legion. 4 years have passed since the Republic held the dam, just barely, against the Legion's onslaught. The Legion did not retreat. Across the river, it gathers strength. Campfires burn, training drums beat. Through it all, the New Vegas Strip has stayed open for business, under the control of its mysterious overseer, Mr. House, and his army of rehabilitated tribals and police robots. You are a courier, hired by the Mojave Express to deliver a package to the New Vegas Strip. What seemed like a simple delivery job has taken a turn for the worse.
You got what you were after, so pay up.
You're crying in the rain, Pally.
Guess who's waking up over here?
Time to cash out.
Will you get it over with?
Maybe cons kill people without looking them in the face. But I ain't a fink. Dig? You've made your last delivery, kid. Sorry you got twisted up in this scene. From where you're kneeling must seem like an 18-carat run of bad luck. Truth is, the game was rigged from the start.
You're awake. How about that? Whoa, easy there, easy. You've been out cold a couple of days now. Why don't you just relax a second? Get your bearings. Let's see what the damage is. How about your name? Can you tell me your name? Can't say it's what I'd have picked for you, but if that's your name, that's your name. I'm Doc Mitchell. Welcome to Good Springs. Now, I hope you don't mind, but I had to go rooting around there in your noggin to pull all the bits of lead out. I take pride in my needlework, but you'd better tell me if I left anything out of place. How'd I do? most of it right anyway. Stuff that mattered. Okay. No sense keeping you in bed anymore. Let's see if we can get you on your feet. Good. Why don't you walk down to the end of the room? Over by that vigor tester machine there. Take it slow now. It ain't a race. Looking good so far. Go ahead and give the vigor tester a try. We'll learn right quick if you got back all your faculties. Yeah, that's a pretty standard score there, but after what you've been through, I'd say that's great news. Well, you know, your vitals are good, but that don't mean them bullets didn't leave you nutter than a bighorn a dropping. What do you say you take a seat in my couch and we go through a couple of questions? See if your dogs are still barking. All right. I'm gonna say a word. I want you to say the first thing that comes to mind. Dog. Before I turn you loose, I need one more thing from you. I got a form for you to fill out so I can get a sense of your medical history. Just a formality. Ain't like I expect to find you got a family history of getting shot in the head. All right, I guess that about does it. Come with me. I'll see you out. Here, these are your... Didn't have much... You... Ever.
You must be the one Doc Mitchell was patching up. The way I heard it, I didn't think you'd be walking out of that office. I've got plenty of... If you're... Thanks. Weapon mods are... There's a...
put in tarnation? Howdy. The one in the fancy suit seemed to be calling.
Cheyenne, stay. Now, see the sarsaparilla bottles on the fence there? Take this and try to hit a couple of them. That's the right idea. Look down the sight. Try crouching down and staying still. It'll help your aim. Nice shot. Well, that's a start. But I don't reckon... Tell you what. Suit yourself. I'm heading... Hey, do me... She'd be...
Done being nice. If you don't hand Ringo over soon, I'm going to get my friends and we're burning this town to the ground. Got it?
I'm not taking
sides. You're fucking dead. Come on.
I hope you didn't just bring a heap of trouble down on Good Springs by killing Joe Cobb like that. His friends might come looking for him, and I... Well... Look... We... They were having some kind of argument about it, but the guy in the checkered coat kept shushing them. Sounded like they came in from the north through Quarry Junction. If that's the case, I can't say I blame them for not wanting to go back. That whole area is overrun with the kind of critters that just get mad if you shoot them. Merchants avoid that whole stretch of I-15 like it's radioactive, which it could be for all I know. I didn't hear exactly, but the leader fellow wants to get there and avoid the 15, he'd have to go east. Take Highway 93 up. There'd be cap. There's always something interesting going on, but the biggest news has to be the coming dust up between the NCR and the Legion over the dam. Slave.
Hey there.
Feeling thirsty? I can take care. Yeah, I heard it turn right back on after you got done tinkering with it. Here's some. Not at all. I'm never sure how much is normally charged for this sort of thing. Here's some additional. Now, how about spending?
Hey there.
I don't think Joe Cobb knew what hit him. I'm hoping you took him down for a good reason and not... Not in good... Most of what's in there is... If you want to take a... If the lock's too much for you to handle, reading through the magazine might give you the edge you need.
That's close enough. So, we got off... thanks, I guess. Cobb wasn't the problem, though. I could have handled him if... Cobb's friends are the bigger problem.
Howdy.
Hi there. Sticking around?
Say no more. I'm in.
Even though Joe Cobb's dead, his friends will come after the town eventually. However, if you could...
A silver tongue would help. Convincing Trudy that we had a good plan to win the fight.
I don't think give is in Chet's vocabulary. Even with the town at stake, he'd still make you barter with him.
Sure can. Take the road southeast out of town. NCR off the... I hunt geckos most... I also... Sure.
So you're planning on taking on... Feeling thirsty? I can take care of that.
Howdy.
You looking to buy some supplies? You made your point. I can provide people with some leather armor and... I'll be guarding the store while all this is going on. Take it.
Welcome back. That Doc Mitchell sure knows his stuff, doesn't he?
You looking to buy some supplies? Can do. Another satisfied customer. Take it.
Thank you.
So what's going on? Did Sunny... Well, I guess that means we're...
Time to look alive. The Powder Gangers are here to play. At least... Oh, Easy Pete came through with the dynamite. Here's your supply. I'll be set.
I owe you a huge favor for this. Here, these are technically Crimson Caravan funds, but I know they'll understand once I explain things. I did have what was left of the Crimson Caravan money, but I wasn't sure if it was my right to just give it away. I owe you more than that, though, so look me up at the Crimson Caravan camp up in New Vegas if you ever visit. Thanks again for all your help. It's a two-player game. The goal is to create caravan bids that beat your opponent's bids, so there's more strategy than luck involved. It's why you won't see caravan in any casino. Too slow-paced. And more importantly, no house edge. Here, take this holotape. It goes into more specific... So... Just keep an eye out for him while you travel. I've found cards in old boxes or forgotten on shelves. Can find some for sale, too. Don't worry. I'm not that...
Hello there. It's good to see you. Don't suppose you'd care to trade? I'm missing a few essentials and... screw this. Lying just ain't in my nature. I'll tell it to you straight. I've been following you for a good bit now. It started off innocently enough. I was traveling, as I often do, and happened to observe you picking up one of those blue star caps. You didn't show any reaction to it, so I figured you didn't know what you'd gotten your hands on. There's an old wasteland legend that says somewhere out there is a fabulous treasure from before the war. Those caps with the blue star on them, the tale goes, are the key to that treasure. They're called Sunset Sarsaparilla Stars. All over the place. The easiest place to find them is unopened bottles of Sunset Sarsaparilla. You'd think they'd all have been picked clean by now, but somehow, new bottles keep appearing in the machines. Some say it's old Festus that does it, hoping someone will finally collect enough caps to earn the treasure. Other than bottles, you'll just have to scavenge. You can find caps in the unlikeliest of places, and blue star caps are no... No problem.
That was a hell of a fight. Let's hope. Another satisfied customer.
Hey. Thanks again for all your help.
Howdy. You looking to buy some supplies? Give me a shout if you need anything else. Hello? Can you help me? My girl is trapped by geckos on the ridge, and I can't get to her. Please, she's going to die. Bastard.